In this video, we'll go from this to this. And I'll show you this by only using one instance of FabFilter Saturn 2. I find myself grabbing the FabFilter Saturn 2 plugin more and more when I want to quickly get a bass drum, toms and snare sound. This video will focus on the bass drum. I covered the snare drum in part 1 and the entire drum kit will follow in part 3. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel so you won't miss out on the rest. Here's the drum part I recorded for these videos. The snare drum was already tweaked in part 1. Here's the soloed bass drum. I divide the frequency spectrum of the bass drum in a few parts. It's globally like this. Between 30 and 80 Hz you have the sub-bass part of the bass drum. It can really go that low. Between 70 and 200 Hz you have the knock of the kick. This is around the first harmonic of the bass drum, and this is the lowest note you can hear on a small speaker. From 180 to 1000 is the tone and character of the bass drum. 1000 to 3500 is the presence, aggressiveness and where the attack starts of the bass drum. And around 3500 all the way up to 10 kHz you have the attack and the air of the bass drum. And by all means, this is not a fixed set of rules, this is my approach. The frequencies I mentioned are guidelines. The exact frequencies will differ from bass drum to bass drum. Here's the recorded bass drum, and I recorded it with only one Sennheiser E602 Mark I microphone. The Sennheiser 602 is a so-called bass drum microphone, which is basically a microphone tailored to sound good on bass drums. And because of that, I want to add some mid-range and tone. This natural kick sounds good, but it's missing something, let's say personality. So first I will add a band over here. And I'll boost the volume a little bit to hear better what is going on. By using this dial, I can either compress or gate. And I'll gate it a little bit to reduce the bleed of snare and toms. I want some extra harmonics and smoothness in this area, so I choose Warm Transformer and dial that in. And now I'll work on the lows and sublows of the bass drum. First I create a band. I solo it and find the sweet spot. It's right around here. And I can do, of course, compressing and gating, but I want to do something else, and that is I will be using this feedback knob. Let's play a bit and turn up the dial so you can hear what happens. You can hear the feedback increasing and getting rather ugly, but here's the cool part. If you dial it in properly by using the gate compression dial, the mix knob and the feedback dial, and set the frequency setting, you can get a real cool low-end extension of the bass drum. Let me show you. So there's a nice extension of the low end for you. Okay, let's work on the attack. First I'll add a band and solo it. Fine-tuning the crossover point. And I'll add some gentle saturation. The bleed of the cymbals gets boosted a bit right now, so I will use the gate. And if I boost this band a lot, you will get a sort of a metal bass drum, which is something I do not want at this point. so I will back off the volume boost a little bit. This leaves us with two bands. The knock of the bass drum and the presence. First, the knock. It doesn't need much. A little bit of gating to make it tighter. And a bit of warm saturation. Okay, now let's work on the presence. Let me tweak these bands a bit. A bit lower, I think. I will do the same here and just tighten it up a bit and add some harmonics to make it sound bigger. Okay, this is now in the mix. Let me unsolo this bass drum. Okay, here's the before, and this is how it sounds after, and before, and after, and one time a solo, this is after, and before, and after. There you have it, bass drum sculpting with Saturn 2. To see all my videos on using Saturn 2 on drums, see my playlist here. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye!